YouTube. Today we're going to make a brand new kitchen table for the cabin. All we're going to need is a couple pieces of pressure treated 2x4 cut in half, so roughly 1¾ inch to 2 inch. And then we're going to need 1 sheet of 5/8 plywood. Could be a little bit thicker if you wanted to, that'll make it a little bit more sturdy. But that's pretty much all we're going to need. We're going to make the tabletop, and we're also going to make some built-in booth seats for it as well, but that'll be part two of this series. So we'll go ahead and start with part one. We're going to go over the materials really quickly, and we'll get started, so stay with me. All right, so the materials you're going to need are very, very simple. Like I said, it's better off if you go ahead and use pressure-treated wood so you don't have to worry about it rotting over time, especially out in the conditions that it's going to be in. They're very humid, so you want to use pressure-treated if you can. If not, then you should be fine as long as it doesn't get wet and stay wet. So the stuff we're going to use, is, like I said, is 2x4 that's been cut down. These are actually 2 inches. We really don't need full-size 2x4s for strength purposes because it's not going to take a whole lot of weight. So 2 inch is plenty enough for that. So these are pressure-treated. This one is not, so we'll try not to use it unless we have to. The actual tabletop is going to be bolted into the wall on one side, and then the other side will only have one leg right here with two 45-degree angle supports, which we'll make out of this, and that'll be plenty strong enough, and it'll give us plenty of room for our feet to get in and out without having to get around the legs and be in the way. So we're going to use that. This is all actually recycled material, so this is all going to be free. And then we're also going to use a sheet of, looks to be half-inch plywood actually. Like I said, it's not going to take a whole lot of support, or it's not going to take a whole lot of weight, so we don't need a whole lot of support, but we'll probably go and throw in a couple cross pieces on our actual frame for the tabletop to support the tabletop in the center. So let's go ahead and we're going to cut down our 2-inch 2x4s right here, and we're going to make our 36-inch by 36-inch square frame. That. So now we have a good nice square tabletop, and so what we can do is when we mount this to our base, it'll actually square up the base. Since this is nice and square, when we go to screw down into it, it will do one side, and then we can adjust this side over here left and right to make it perfectly square. So we're almost done with our table, guys. Stay with me. Perfect. All right, so if we cut everything properly, which I'm fairly sure we did, this should come out. And make sure we pick the best side here, the side that's not cracked. That's got a, or it's got a split in it, so, well, that side's definitely ugly, so we'll go with this one. If we did our math right, this should line up perfectly. That side is good. Like I said, we can fix the square as soon as we screw in this side, then we can adjust that side accordingly, but that is a very, very nice fit right there. Flush on every side, that's exactly what I want. The next thing, as you can see, I'm doing here is I got the table upside down, and I took the 2x4, which is going to be our one leg on this side, and just stood it up here and stand it by itself. The best way to secure it, you can toenail it, which would work, but this is going to be a little bit stronger. I'm going to take a piece of plywood and scab it on, and we'll drill 2 into the table and 2 into the leg, and that'll give it a lot of stability this way. And then I have a 45-degree brace right here. And that will give it the strength it needs the other way. Since I'm not pre-drilling, I'll go ahead and throw a clamp on the 2x4 and the scab to keep it from moving around too much while I do this. We're also going to take a speed square here and just make sure we're square before we completely screw it in. And we should be good to go. Give us plenty of strength this way and tighten up those screws a little bit. So now all we have to do is put our brace in right here. All right, guys, so we're down here in the cabin, and the first thing I went ahead and did is put a block up onto the wall. This is just mounted to the wall directly with some screws in from the backside. These are going to be temporary because we're actually going to put in some good sized bolts through here to really support the table well. So all this is a piece of 2x2 pressure treated, and what we're going to do is we're going to drill through. We're going to go straight through the block, straight into the wall, and then we're going to set the table up and finish drilling out our holes in every single piece that we're using, and then we're going to run a bolt through all of that. And we're going to do one here and one on the other side of the 2x4, which will be another block of wood that we're going to have to put there. So go ahead and drill a hole on this side. Try and do it as straight and square as you can. All right. And then we're going to put the other block up, set the table up, and we'll come out to the outside wall and drill from the outside in to finish our hole through the tabletop itself. Well, everybody, here's the finished product. We just finished bolting it to the wall, and we actually had a camp out a couple nights ago in it, and it worked very, very well. Nice to have a larger table to be able to accommodate more than 3 people. We have 4 people down here a lot. Sometimes even 5, so it's nice to be able to accommodate that many people on a bigger table. As you can see, it's very solid. It's not going to go anywhere. Super, super strong. Very simple, lightweight construction, however. So this will be part 1 of the series. Part 2, we'll be putting in some booth seats as well to match. And hopefully we'll be getting that taken care of very soon. It's been really snowy lately. It dumped about 4 inches on us yesterday. So we'll see how soon we can get that done. But in the meantime, y'all, take care, and thank you for watching part 1. And we'll see you again for part 2 really soon. I'd like to take a moment very quickly to thank my new sponsor, Burke Brothers Hardware, for providing me with a lot of tools that I needed to complete this project, definitely including this really nice drill that they gave to me as well. Burke Brothers Hardware has been a family business ever since they started in 1936, so they're going on about 80 years now, and they're located just a stone's throw away from the Raleigh Fairgrounds in North Carolina. So If you're ever around the area and you'd like to find a good product for at a good price, then go ahead and stop on by and tell them I sent you. They're not the biggest store around, but they really specialize in quality customer service, and they tend to have a lot of products that are specific and things that the big box stores really don't carry. So if you're ever in the area, go ahead and check them out. If you're not and you want to be able to access their products, they also have an online store at www.burkebrothershardware.com.